Hello and welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we are going to talk about one of the most common problem in compressor, high temperature shutdown. If you have ever faced a situation where your compressor suddenly trips and stops working and the HMI screen show high temperature trip, then this video is for you. I will not only show you the actual shutdown condition on HMI, but also explain which parameters were abnormal at that time. Let's begin by checking the HMI screen. Here you can see the compressor status is showing shutdown. The main reason is high temperature trip. Now if we look at the parameter during shutdown, at that time compressor outlet pressure was 7.2 bar and receiver pressure was 7.5 bar. Bearing lubrication oil pressure was 3.9 bar and controller temperature 38.7 degree, element 1 outlet temperature 123.6 degree, cooling air in 32.3 degree, bearing lubrication oil temperature 42.3 degree, ambient air 36.5 degree, compressor outlet 40.2 degree, oil injection 71.2 degree, and other parameters are normal. And you can see all parameters like overload, fan motor okay, starting feedback contact okay, overload fan motor okay, condensate drain AC no water, DP bearing lubrication 3.6 bar, and delta T element 52.4 degree. DT motor cooler 28.9 bar. As you see, only compressor outlet temperature was very high. That is the reason this compressor is on shutdown. This clearly showed that the compressor was forced to stop automatically to protect itself from overheating. Now the big question is, why does this happen? Here are the most common causes of a high temperature shutdown. So I will explain all the causes that will impact on temperatures. As you seen, if the compressor oil filter is choked, then the oil pressure reduced and the oil temperature will be increased. That is the reason why its temperature will increase. If the oil level is low, as you see this gauge, if the oil level is low, then temperature will increase automatically. And the next possible thing is that if the thermostat valve not working properly at that time will also increase the temperature of compressor oil. And if the compressor temperature sensor not working properly, that time also it will give you shutdown. You can see this temperature sensor jack. If there is a problem of compressor high temperature, that time you can clean this jack and temperature sensor with contact cleaner. If there is any rust, it will clean all of that and show you actual temperature of that oil. You can clean this, and after cleaning try this jack, and after try you can put on sensor jack. This is a contact cleaner, as you see, Philips company. This jack is going to dry. After dry, we will again install on sensor. And the next possible thing is that compressor outlet temperature sensor. If the compressor outlet temperature showing you high, then you can also clean this sensor and jack with contact cleaner. if the other things are okay and your temperature sensor is clean, after that it will showing high temperature, you need to change temperature sensor. It may have a problem in the temperature sensor, so you will must change this temperature sensor. Next possible is thing is that if your oil cooler is dirty, that time also increase your temperature. You must check and clean this cooler, and your cooler will be clean properly. Next possible thing is that if your suction filter is blocked, air filter create suction, increase load and rises the temperature. You must clean your air filter. If the motor bearing lubrication temperature showing high, you must check the oil filter of bearing oil and also check the line, there is no leakage, and the level of oil. Our compressor is on shutdown because of outlet temperature is high. We check other all things that were okay. So we find problem in oil filter. Now we all drain oil from oil filter and open oil filter with the help of belt, and we will replace this oil filter and install new oil filter. Now we are going to open this oil filter for replacement. As you see, this oil came from the filter. We remove old filter from the compressor and going to install new filter on this compressor. This is our other filter. We are replacing this oil filter. Our oil filter is installed on the compressor. After this filter installation, I will start my compressor and show you all parameter. If there is any kind of problem, I will explain you. After replacing the filter, you must check all other things like drain valve is closed, your compressor outlet valve will be open. Now we are going to open this valve for startup. Now our valve is open, and check lubricant level. Our lubricant level is okay. Oil cooler are clean, and temperature sensor are installed properly, and remove cotton if there is any particle of cotton, and check all things. If all things are okay, then we will going to remove emergency. We remove emergency and reset. Now we are going to adjust set point of compressors. Load unload point. Our unloading point will be 7.2 bar and loading point 7 bar. Now I have started compressor, and I will show you all parameter while our compressor is on running condition. Compressor is working fine. These are all the parameter of compressors. All parameter are under limits. You can check element 1 outer temperature is now 79 degree. After starting of compressor, touch the filter. If your filter is hot, it means your filter is passing the oil properly, and check all parameters. All parameters are normally. So friends, remember, a high temperature shutdown is not a fault to ignore. It's actually a safety feature to protect your compressor from major damage. Always make sure to keep the cooling system clean, check oil level and quantity and quality regularly, and place air filter on time. By following these preventive steps, you can avoid unplanned shutdown, reduce maintenance cost, and increase the life of your compressor. Thanks for watching. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more practical compressor troubleshooting videos. Thank you very much.